Hey guys, welcome to this video on finding the area and perimeter of an object. The area and perimeter help us to measure two-dimensional shapes. The area measures the surface of an object, and the perimeter measures the length of the outside of an object. For instance, let's say you have a rectangular pool, and you want to find a tarp to cover it. Then you would need to know the area of the surface of the pool. So everything on the inside here. But if you wanted to know the distance it would take to walk around the outside of the pool, then you would need to know the perimeter. Now let's take a look at how to calculate each one. First, perimeter. To calculate the perimeter of any polygon, you just add up the length of all the sides. Let's use our rectangular pool as an example. Let's say that the width is 15 feet and that the length is 7 feet. Since it's a rectangle, we know that their parallel sides have the exact same length. So that makes this side over here 7 feet and this side right here 15 feet because these sides are parallel and these are parallel. So we have all the information we need. Now we just add up all the sides. Let's start with our formula. Let's say 15 is equal to A and 7 is equal to B. So we have perimeter is equal to A plus A plus B plus B. Now let's plug in our numbers. So we have perimeter is equal to A, so that's 15 plus 7 plus 7. So then we add it all up and we get our perimeter is equal to 44 feet. We can even simplify our perimeter formula for a rectangle. Since we know that there are four sides, and that there are two sets of identical sides, you know, the two sides that are parallel to each other. We can then simplify our formula for perimeter to be perimeter is equal to 2 times A plus B. Let's try and see if we get the same thing. So you can see here that we do indeed get the same thing. We can apply this same sort of principle to finding the perimeter of a square. Since a square has four sides that are the same measurement, we can say that the perimeter of a square is 4 times A, since all the sides are equal. So we have square. And the same principle is true with an equilateral triangle. All three sides are the same, so we can say that its perimeter is equal to 4. An isosceles triangle has two sides that are the same, so we can write our perimeter formula as 4. Now, the only shape whose perimeter may seem a little less obvious to find is our friend, the circle. You guys may have heard of the term circumference. Well, the circumference is the exact same thing as the perimeter of a circle. Some mathematicians may get a little on edge about which term you use, because technically perimeter is defined as the sum of the lengths of the edges of a closed figure, and a circle doesn't have edges. But the definition for circumference is the perimeter of a circle. So whichever way you prefer to call it, let's look at how you find it. To find the circumference of a circle, first you draw your circle. So you have your midpoint, diameter, and then your radius. Well, to find the circumference, you multiply the diameter times pi. All right, now on to area. When we're looking at the perimeter of different shapes, we're able to simplify the formulas, giving us different formulas for different shapes, yet keeping in line with the definition of adding up all the sides. Well, similarly, when finding the area of an object, the formula will be different for different shapes, but each formula represents a solution to solving for the area of the object's surface. So let's take a look at the different shapes in the area formula corresponding for each shape. First, we have the parallelogram. Okay, now let's look at some examples of how to solve for the area of an ellipse and the area of a trapezoid. All right, now let's say you have an ellipse. And let's say that we have Our A is equal to 6, and our B is equal to 4. Now, all we need to do is plug in our numbers into the formula we have for an ellipse. Now, let's say we have a trapezoid. We'll say that our height is equal to 7. Our A side is equal to 8. And our B side is equal to 5. So now, we do the exact same thing we did last time. We just plug in our numbers into our formula for area. Alright guys, I hope that this video has been helpful. If you guys enjoyed it, hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for further videos. See you guys next time.